Hello guys, welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. My name is Shivam Vijay and today in this video I am going to giving a demonstration on microhydraulic trainer. With this trainer kit we can understand the working of hydraulic technology right now, which is a very essential need in the industry, and also we will familiarize with some of the basic components of hydraulic. So as we know, in industrial automation today all the type of machines are required to work automatically and modernized system. This is required to generate the efficient process and to generate the capability of production higher and to less consumption of manpower. And to perform the machinery automatically, we require to do the electromechanical interface. The electromechanical interface is nothing but a mechanical movement which is controlled by some of the electrical signals. And to achieve this electrical motion, we require some type of energy resources, and most commonly used and readily available resources are air and some specific type of liquids. The atmospheric air is compressed with the help of compressors, and it can be easily provided to any of the components of pneumatic or air operated to generate the pressure. And this pressure is further changed into the mechanical motion to operate any of the mechanical movement. In same way, the liquids are also stored in huge tanks and can be used for generating the specific pressure. And this generated pressure is further used for mechanical driving force to operate the any of mechanical motion. Some highly pressurized liquids are used to drive the any of mechanical components are called hydraulic liquids. And the component which are worked with this type of highly pressurized liquid are called the hydraulic components, and which can be easily executed by electrical excitations. Some of the components of hydraulic work with the electrical excitation, whereas some of the component work with the semi-automated form, in which there is a starting purpose for excitation is provided from manually and the rest of the work is done through the mechanical force or the hydraulic force. And this micro hydraulic trainer is specially designed to see the executing of hydraulic component with the manually excitation or manually execution. So now we move on to the kit description. We will study all the components one by one, and later on we will perform the hydraulic working and hydraulic mechanical motion on this trainer board. So this is the specially designed case for this type of hydraulic components, in which all the components are inside this the container, and we can easily move this container to any of your place while working to study and to explain the working of this hydraulic components or hydraulic working. Now we are going to open this trainer board and let us see what inside this. So after opening this, we will find some of the electrical components or the hydraulic components. So we now let's have the closer look of all the items provided in this kit. So this is the tubes which are working as the inlet and outlet line. These are the extra tubes. So this is the first inlet tube, which is a transparent tube and has a larger diameter than other of the tubes because we required higher pressure to be sucked inside. Then this is the outlet tube of this pressure line. Also there is an cap provided to block the output of this, so that any of the material or any of the hard material inside the pump cannot be sucked easily, or in the non-working condition the water flow will not go outside or will not flow inside the tank. So I will explain you all the components one by one. For this we start with this double acting cylinder. This is the double acting cylinder which works in two motions. When we provide the pressure from backside, the cylinder piston movement will be in forward direction, and when we provide pressure from the front end, the cylinder movement will be in the reverse direction. Then we have the 5x3 hydraulic control direction control valve. in which there are three ports in this side and there are two ports for the output. The pressurized line will be going input from this middle port and can be go from A to provide the reverse motion and can be go from B from providing the forward motion to the double acting cylinder. At the same time, when we provide the forward motion, the amount or the filled water inside the front end will be required to release through any of the tank wall. So when we operate this in the forward motion, the reverse direction current or the reverse direction flow of water as a medium right now we are using will be flow through the tank or the outlet line. Both are the outlet line. Whenever the flow is forward or reverse, this will flow the return line and the tank line will be connected with this output. Then we have a pressure gauge or the pressure manifold. This manifold contains the pressure output line and also the input pressure sug will be going through this. Over here, a pressure gauge at which we can determine and set the required pressure for working of this operation. Then we have pressure regulator valve, so that when we require the output pressure or inlet pressure can be controlled with this valve. Then we have tank manifold. In this, the output from the return lines will be going to the outlet line and the tank line through the valve are also connected at this manifold as well. And we are also providing the flow control valve FCV. For this, A and B outlet can be easily connected through the pressure line whenever we require to control the forward and reverse direction speed, so that according to the flow, as the flow is increased, the speed will also increase, and if the flow is decreased, the speed will also decrease of the movement. And for electrical controls, we have a pump inside this which is already installed behind this plate, and it can easily be turned on and off with this on off switch provided here, and there is a 1 ampere fuse also provided for protection of this pump. The pump can be easily used to suck the water or any of the liquid for operating this, and a specific hydraulic liquid are required to use to operate the mechanical motion. The working of the pump can easily be done by 230 volt power supply. So this is all about the description of all the components. Now we move on to the practical working of this trainer board. For this, we will follow the procedure as described in this user manual. So first of all, we need a tank of about 10 to 20 liters of water capacity. We are using water as a liquid for this for operation, and these are the inlet and outlet line. Both lines are to be dipped in the water tank. Also, make sure you turn out this cap from this before inserting it and dipping it into the water tank. Now we'll dip both the lines inside the water tank and make sure, as we have provided a gap already between inlet and outlet, but make sure both the lines should be at some of the distance, so that whenever the pressure is coming from the return line, the water bubble will not go and suck inside the water pump. We do not need any of the bubbles inside the complete line. Now we can on the pump after connecting it to the power supply with this pump on off button. So as I on the pump button, the pump starts working, and let it be continuously run in the 1 or 2 minutes, so that all the bubbles inside the air line will be removed and continuous flow inside the line will be working on. So our bubbles has been removed completely, and now we can adjust the pressure on the pressure gauge from 2 to 5 kg per centimeter square, which is required enough to operate the cylinder. Now for this, we can use this pressure release valve to increase the pressure. Slowly open this pressure release valve so that pressure inside the tank and the pressure gauge will be going stable, and and ready to the experiment of forward and reverse movement. So our pressure has been set. Now we will turn on the pump again and see the movement with this hand operated 5x3 directional control valve. So I'll again on the pump. See, the pressure is in between 3 to 5 kilogram per centimeter square, and now we can move this lever in any of the direction, in up and down, and we can observe the working of mechanical motion. So I will turn this to the downside and we can see the cylinder goes in forward motion. Now it is again in the center position, so we can do not increase this as the stroke of the cylinder is completely open. Now we need to operate this valve in the upwards direction so that the cylinder go inside and we can get the reverse motion. So this is the reverse motion completely done. Similarly, we can do the forward motion again, and this is the reverse motion. Now I will explain you what is going on right now with this lines and with this mechanical movement. So here we can see right now pressure is coming inside to the pressure manifold and it is going through the P port for this directional control valve. And whenever we actuate any of the movement with this lever, so that when we operate this to the lower side, pressure from the pressure line goes through the B line and goes behind the piston, and inside filled water will be coming out through the return line and through the A port. The A port is connected and open when we open and pull this lever in the downwards direction. The open A port will be open to the tank and P port will be connected with the pressure line, so that pressure will be go behind the piston and the inside water filled will be going to the tank. The tank line will be directly going to the return line in this return manifold, so that whenever we pull this lever in backwards or downwards direction, the process go on and forward movement achieved. Now in the same case, vice versa action will happen. When we pull this hand lever in the upwards direction, A line will be connected with the pressure line and B port will be connected with the tank line, so that when we pressurize the A line and line will be and water inside the tank or the inside the cylinder will start filling, the piston will be moved backwards and the backward filled water will be going through the return line, through the tank port to the tank manifold and then to the return line of the tank. So that's how reverse motion will also achieve. So still we have achieved the forward and reverse movement, and I have explained the concept and working of the hydraulic lever control valve. Now we will study the working of flow control valve. For flow controlling, we just need to turn off the pump, wait for a while so that water inside the line will be going out completely, and then we can connect any of the line A or B through the pressure control valve. For this, if you want to control the forward pressure or forward speed of the cylinder, we need to add this flow control valve in the A line, so that whenever the return line is in the blockage mode or the return pressure is less than through the inlet pressure, the speed will be controlled accordingly, so that we can easily control the speed of the movement or the time for the movement also. Of forward direction, we need to control the A line which is passing through with this flow control valve. For forward direction, we just need to pull out this tube and connect this tube passing through this A line. so that A, which is going through directly, will be going first with the B line, B point over here, and then will it is connected with the A line. If you connect this in reverse direction, there will be the reverse action going on, because it will control the B to A line for the controlling, and in return line this will going directly through the non-return wall. So for this we just need to connect the extra PU tubes provided with this trainer kit on this flow control wall. Then we need to remove this line and we will connect the flow control wall in this line. For pulling out the PU tubes, just do carefully connections like as I am doing. Just press this blue section properly and pull the tube. If you try to pull the tube directly without pushing the blue section, this will not come out and it will break the PU fitting. So do not apply as much as force for pulling this. Just carefully press this blue section and your tube will be easily coming out without any excessive force. Now for connecting the PU tube, just make sure you are connecting the B point. Just push this tube inside and it will automatically clipped, and B line, B point will be directly connected to the A point for the proper function, and A line or the output of this flow control wall will be connected with the inlet point or the front end point of the double acting cylinder. So this is our connection process has been done. Make sure all the tubes are properly fitted so there will be no leakage of water. If the at this high pressure, if water leakage, that might be dangerous for the personnels. Now we will see how the forward movement is controlled with the flow control valve. Now we'll on the pump and make sure the flow control valve has the at least some of the opening to completely make the flow. So we have opened the flow control valve slightly, and now if I move this cylinder to forward position, we can observe the forward action is slower than the earlier section, and if we observe the reverse action will be as per the conventional speed, which is very fast rather than the forward movement. If I control the flow control valve some more, we can decrease the forward speed also more slower. Here you can see the flow control valve is completely blocked. So if I slightly release the pressure by moving this in anti-clockwise direction, there will be some of amount of the pressure, and here you can see the forward movement is quite slower than the earlier. If you increase the pressure, the movement is also increased. The speed of movement is also increased. In similar action, you can control the reverse direction as well. For this, either you can change the direction of A and B. So if you want to control the B section, you can change the direction reversely and the reverse action can be done. For controlling the reverse action, we just need to exchange the lines from B to A and A to B. Properly and carefully open these lines. Here, right now we have just completed the practical, so there might be some of the water inside the lines present. Here, now if I connect the A line to B and B line to A point, or operation of direction or the speed movement is now changes. It will now control the reverse direction as the return line from the B is now controlled. Make sure all the connection is properly tightened and proper fitting has been done of all the PU tube. Now we will start the pump again and see this time the reverse cycle is slowed down than the forward cycle. So motor has been started and now we will reversely see the direction and the speed of the cylinder or piston is slower in this case. And for forward movement, it is at the normal speed. If I close the flow control valve in some amount more, we can achieve there is slightly more slower speed. So you can control your desired speed with this flow control valve. So as we control the flow, as we control the speed. The forward movement remains at the same speed. So this was the practical description of mini micro hydraulic trainer. After doing your practical, just carefully pull out the tubes. Make sure you remains the original position of all the lines. For that, you just need to remove the air sucking line from the water tank and then 4 to 3 times just move this piston like this so that any residual pressure will be completely gone out from the tubings. Then you can easily fold up your pipes and again block the inlet with this blocking cap so that you can easily store the inside water inside the pipelines. So before pulling the water inlet and outlet line, make sure all the water will be drained out properly to the tank. Drain out as much as water you can from this inlet suction line. And then cover this suction line with this cap. And after that, you can easily fold it and place this inside. So that was the complete demonstration of micro hydraulic trainer. I hope you get the proper conceptual knowledge and practical knowledge about the hydraulic working of hydraulic components. Also, how the mechanical movement can be achieved by different type of liquids. So you can perform and study all the hydraulic working with this user manual and as I suggested and described in this video also. And if you still find difficulties, you can contact to Tesca Technologies Private Limited for all types of supports. If you like this video, you can please press the like button. Also you can share this video for your colleagues, your friends and your classmates, those who want to learn about the hydraulic system and how the hydraulic basics works. And you can also subscribe our channel. There are a lot of videos with the practical informative information are uploaded for different type of educational trainers. Also, don't forget to press the bell button so whenever we upload a new video, you will be notified about that as well. Till then, thank you for watching this video and we will meet in the next video very soon.